Okay, let's talk asbestos. That one word that scares the hell out of everybody. Okay, full disclosure here. I'm a general home inspector. I am not a licensed, qualified asbestos abatement professional. You should always contact a qualified professional to remove any type of asbestos materials that may be in your home to avoid accidental exposure. Let's go. So what I got in front of me here are two good specimens of materials that I commonly find in a house during a home inspection. Okay, so this first piece right here is called transite. As you can see, the T is missing right there. T-R-A-N-S-I-T-E. And this pipe is commonly found inside older homes, anywhere from early 1900s all the way up to the 1970s, I see this pipe. This here is used for heating systems, for the exhaust venting, and also water heater systems for the exhaust venting. A lot of times when I go into a house, I'll go into a garage, for example, and I'll see the water heater, and then I look up and then all the way up to the ceiling framing, and I see a piece of this still in place where they connected a new metal flue right here to the bottom. So that would be like this in a vertical fashion. And right here, they have a piece of metal connected to this. So what they chose to do is just only replace some of it, not all of it. So that's a pretty common thing I find. It shouldn't be a problem as long as you're not, you know, disturbing it, like cutting into it or breaking it open. Because this contains a blue asbestos, which is the fine, sharp edge particles which can get into your lungs. So just so you know, before I started this video, I took these outside and I hosed them down and get rid of any kind of dust or loose parts of it that might have been hanging off there. So trying to protect myself while making this video. Okay, so you're probably wondering, well, how do I know this is asbestos? Well, I actually had these pieces tested. So let's start right here with the transite. So I got the lab results back, and the transite pipe has come back positive for two types of asbestos materials. One of those materials is crocidolite, which is at 20%, and then crocidolite, which is at 35%. Now, crocidolite is the more dangerous of the two asbestos materials because it has very sharp edges on it. So when it gets into your nose or into your lungs, it actually sticks to your lungs, and that's the danger part of it. And that's what can turn into cancerous problems. So I did have it tested, and I had it tested out of my own curiosity. Because all I've ever been told is, oh, that looks like asbestos, or yeah, that's a pretty common knowledge that that's asbestos. But I was just like, well, why am I taking someone's word for it? So I just had it all tested, and that's why I'm here today, to show you guys what's going on with this stuff. So this is something that you don't want to cut into. You do not want to hit it with a hammer and break it apart, because those dust particles get in the air and you can breathe it in. So as in some of my other videos you might have already seen, I'm a big fan of wearing a respirator when I go into attics and crawl spaces. And this is one of the reasons why, because many times I crawl into an attic, somebody has had their way with this stuff, cut it, they cut it with a saw or a power tool, and they left pieces all over the place. And then I'll see big chunks of it, like, you know, 4 or 5 inch pieces all scattered about the attic, mixed in with the insulation. So as a homeowner, I'd be careful going into your attic. I would definitely wear a nice respirator before you go in if you've never been in there before, just so you can personally see what's going on in your attic. But if it's all broken up all over the place, have a professional come in and do it so they remove it properly so you don't get any exposure. This type of material is known to contain asbestos. So once again, I just decided to have it tested on my own, and the results came back positive for crocidolite at 55%. So there's a large amount of asbestos in this wrap right here. Now under this wrap is just metal. That's just metal. That's why it's all rusted. You can see it's all rusted up. It's all rusted. So it's just really old. And So this definitely did contain it. And when I find this, it's typically in multiple areas, because most houses have multiple rooms and you're going to have a supply register for each room in most cases. So that's why we're going to see multiple sections of this. Now, I oftentimes see this where new HVAC ducting was installed, but they didn't replace this and they didn't encapsulate this. So that's what we're looking for when you're inspecting your house, you know, little deficiencies and upgrades and so forth. And that would be one of them right there for the HVAC. Okay, so the takeaway from this video is real simple. If there's asbestos materials in your house, you don't want to mess with it. So if you just had your home inspected and your home inspector is telling you there's materials in there that may contain asbestos, whether they're still in service or not, call an abatement professional for asbestos and then have them come in and further evaluate what's going on, because you don't want to have any accidental exposure for you or your family.